stay with us until beyond 3 o'clock in the morning. We've seen a terrific 10,000 metres, and Dave run at a very challenging pace indeed.
It wasn't, and the Europeans dominated it. Vaquero from Spain took many of the laps early on, and Ribeiro from Portugal. They weren't acting as a team, but it had the right effect, took it on occasionally. And all the African athletes and Wang Yongsi from China were happy to sit in. But that began to soften the rest down. And Ribeiro, really tactically, it was a marvellous race, because she was exposed at the front with two laps to go. And I think had Wang, this is coming up to 600 to go, and Ribeiro's in the front, two Ethiopians in third and fourth, and Wang Yongsi there, who'd already won the 5,000 metres and was favourite for this, makes a late bid for home. And really, that might have been her mistake. 600 metres is a long way to go, and there must have been times during that last 600 that she thought, she wondered to herself whether she'd done the right thing. And Ribeiro was brilliant, because the only thing you can do at this point is just hang on as closely as you can. Wang Yongsi had made a challenge. There was no turning back, no slowing down. And for Ribeiro, it's just trying to maintain contact and hold the form.
She did that pretty well, but what about 200 metres on from this point? Wang Yongsi appeared to have it won.
She did. I mean, Wang Yongsi going down the back straight had a gap, 4 or 5 metre gap, but that isn't a decisive gap. So the 10 metres, and you think, well, there's no way back. 4 or 5 metres. At this point, you probably would have thought Wang Yongsi was going to go away. But again, Ribeiro holds the form. There's no strain, particularly. She keeps her form and knows that she's got one more gear change. And if she can just hold on to Wang Yongsi. And again, all this time, over the last 200 metres, the gap really isn't extending. It's not really narrowing. But Ribeiro knows that one more kick, one more lift, one more effort, and she could bridge the gap. And another slight mistake that Wang Yongsi makes, and it's one we all make, actually, is to drift out wide, because she didn't expect anyone to come on the inside. And at this point, when Ribeiro goes past Wang Yongsi, there is no way that you can respond. It's the best place to overtake someone, you know, 20 or 30 metres from home.
How conscious would Wang Yongsi have been of the challenge emerging down the home straight there?
Probably not conscious of it. I didn't notice her look up at the screen, because if you look up at the screen, she could have seen her behind. She knew that Ribeiro wouldn't be far behind, but she probably thought she'd done enough. And she certainly wouldn't have been aware that Ribeiro was going to come on the inside. But I think even if Wang Yongsi had been on the inside, Ribeiro would have gone wide. She had more left.
Great tactical race, as you say. What does it tell us about the gulf, if indeed there is one, between European distance running and African and Asian?
I think the gulf is bigger in the men's than in the women's. I think the men's male African runners are stronger in depth than the women, but the women are getting better. But no, I think it's brilliant. I mean, Ribeiro's now shown that European women can win titles. Paula Radcliffe, Kelly Holmes from Britain have already done very, very well. And, we have to have a very positive attitude towards taking on the Africans. It's an exciting period in distance running, particularly, for those that have the ability to take the great Africans on. And, Ribeiro really proved today that she is a great athlete, European champion, world champion, and now, the really big one, the Olympic title.
Well, that's the Olympic action tonight in the Olympic Stadium. Tomorrow, the last night of athletics and 1500-meter finals, and hope for Britain in the 4x400 as well.
Well, our 4x4 team really could do very well. It's been 60 years since we won the Olympics. The British record is, in fact, we're the second fastest nation ever, Britain. When we won it in 1991, the World Championships, the time that the British athletes did then made us the second fastest nation. But the USA have actually got about 6 or 7 times faster than us. But now Michael Johnson isn't running, Butch Reynolds isn't running. It really makes it very interesting. And I think the Britons are capable of breaking the British record and really capable of winning the gold. It'll be a great climax to the Games.
Could be one last overdue celebration for us tomorrow night. Dave, for the moment, thanks very much indeed.